So now we are back to the wholly obtained or produced. So to qualify as originating, we know it must either be completely born and raised, completely manufactured from all the materials. So 100% NAFTA. Complete or complete tariff shift. Successfully, or must be wholly obtained and produced. All right, so let's talk about what this buzzword, and I put this in quotation marks because this is a term of art, what this buzzword means, wholly obtained and produced. So now we are back to the wholly obtained and produced. So to qualify as originating, we know it must either be completely born and raised, completely manufactured from all the materials. So 100% NAFTA. Complete or complete tariff shift. Successfully, or must be wholly obtained and produced. All right, so let's talk about what this buzzword, and I put this in quotation marks because this is a term of art, what this buzzword means, wholly obtained and produced. So for what, and this is important to talk about this, because a lot of customs broker exam questions, they relate to this wholly obtained and produced concept. All right, so number one, mineral goods extracted in the territory of one or more of NAFTA parties. Okay, so that makes sense. Vegetable goods harvested in the territory of one or more NAFTA parties. So here comes the first question, and it relates to vegetable goods. So the phrase goods wholly obtained or produced entirely in the territory of Canada, Mexico, and the United States refers to all of the following except, and here we have vegetable goods exception, right? But why? Well, take a look. As such goods are defined in the schedule, imported in the territory of one or more of NAFTA parties. No, it must be harvested, not imported in the territory of one or more NAFTA parties. If it's imported into the territory of one or more NAFTA parties, unless it comes from the other party, which this answer does not imply, then it will not qualify. So here comes the exception. It must be harvested in the territory, not imported in the territory of one or more NAFTA parties. This imported word makes it inapplicable for the vegetable goods. Therefore, it is our answer choice because we're looking for exception. But as a way to check and to build our platform to jump into the further discussion of the wholly obtained and produced principle, let's talk about A through D also. So mineral goods extracted in the territory of one or more NAFTA parties is a correct statement because this is the first criteria on the list. Live animals born or raised in the territory of one or more NAFTA parties, well, that's right there, right? Here. Live animals born or raised in the territory of one or more NAFTA parties is a verbatim, right? Fits B. So B is correct. Goods obtained from hunting, trapping, or fishing in the territory of one or more NAFTA parties. This is a fourth on the list. Hunting, trapping, or fishing in the territory of more NAFTA parties. making C also a correct answer choice. D provides for goods produced on board of the factory ships from the goods referred to in subdivision A and V, which talks about general note 12 A and V. And here we are going to wholly obtained or produced, which is on page 8. N5, right? This is the reference. And this is, by the way, where I take the outline from. And the factory ships, we find out later about them. But here's the sixth point. Goods obtained on board of factory ships is the correct answer. Now, produced on board of factory ships, there must be some production taking place. And this particular question refers to the offshore trawlers or the ships that follow the fishing vessels. And instead of returning to the shore, it makes more sense for the fishing vessel to come to that ship and offload its catch, so it can be it can start unpacking right away, so that fishing vessel can go back and get more catch because it is limited in space. And rather than going once they far out in sea, it makes more sense for the fleet of fishing vessels to unite with a particular factory ship, which follows along, because first of all, it saves time because the ship does not have to go back to, and forth to shore to offload. It can, it has the factory ship here and there, number one. And it's not only saves on time, it also saves on fuel and saves and results in money saving efficiencies.